All right. Well, I got AR-15s here. So, yeah, these are real cheap.
You want to hold one? Do you have your ID?
Yeah.
You got your driver's license?
No.
Well, how are you going to buy a gun? You don't have a driver's license.
Remember, don't point it at anybody.
Yeah.
You got to get you guys on a background check, too.
Yeah, you're going to. Could you pass the background check?
Little criminals.
Yeah, that's a shotgun.
It's just like ours, huh?
Except yeah. In fact, I have a lady coming to look at this in about 5 minutes. Yeah, this is an 870, 12 gauge shotgun pump.
We don't have that back one. We only have the trigger.
Oh, yeah?
The back is down and then the trigger.
Oh, yeah? Huh. You mean you got a sawed off shotgun? Yeah, that's illegal, you know.
Hey, Mal.
Hey, what's going on?
I came to pick up my shotgun.
Oh, just happened to
have it. The Remington 870.
Yep, right here. Waiting for you.
Right.
See that? Pump shotgun, right. 870, 12 gauge. You sure that's not too much for you?
Positive.
Yeah.
Positive.
Well, you're a big girl. You can handle it.
I can handle it.
Yep.
Very good. Thank you very much. I'm going to make it all tactical looking.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You going to do it yourself?
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's good. All right. Well, good luck with that. You know, it comes with the Dragon guarantee.
Perfect.
60 feet, 60 minutes, whatever comes first. Yep. And you already used 5 minutes talking to me.
I got my new shotgun. Now, it is time to accessorize. I have all different kinds of things to make this more tactical looking. I got my Surefire flashlight, and I've got, of course, my new stock. I have to replace the stock. And sights, and you know, an extractor, and sear pins, and kind of replace some of the stock stuff. And I think it needs to be painted. Okay, so I have some of my camo paint, and I have a stencil. Of course, I've never done this before, but I've watched a few videos, and so I think I'm an expert now. I think I'm gonna take the stock off. I don't have to, because I actually have another one that I'm gonna be putting on it, but I think I'm gonna take the stock off so I can paint it without it, get it all prepped. So before I start my paint job, I thought I should drill and tap the holes for my rear sight. So I have it all clamped, and now I'm going to mark the center of the holes with my transfer punch. There we go. Now we just have to thread it. Okay, it's all the way through. So I'm going to go ahead and remove the trigger assembly. I already tapped these little pins out from the side to then remove the trigger assembly. So now I'm going to wash it really good with some Simple Green, make sure I get all the oil off of it so the paint sticks. And of course I'm going to put the barrel back on before we spray paint it. About 3 light coats of the base coat, which is the lightest color. Whoa. Oops. Well, I hope I didn't overdo it with the string. I guess if I screw it up, I can paint it over again, but
I couldn't get the pattern thing to work, so I'm trying the string thing. All right, here you go. Oh, we got her wrapped again. I hope this turns out. We'll let it dry for a few more minutes and then we'll unwrap it and see what it looks like. I think she's gonna look great. So, looks really good. All right. Like it just came out of the jungle.
Do it again.
Okay. All right, so now I'm going to put a little bit of a matte finish on it. I dusted it a little bit with that original lighter color just to soften it, you know, so it doesn't look so bold. So I think it turned out pretty good. It's the first time I've ever done anything like this. I just watched a couple YouTube videos on how to do this, and so this is just proof that anybody can do it. So now we're gonna put all the accessories on there. So we're replacing the extractor. So I already replaced it with the new one, but it's pretty easy to put in. There's a little spring right here. You just push this back and, you know, back away, and then this lifts off and you can put the new one on. But if you notice the difference between the one that came from the factory and the one that we just put in, it's a pretty big difference. Basically how it works is it hooks on to the round and extracts it. So the next we're going to replace the sear spring. Basically, this is a 5-pound factory trigger pull. We're going to replace it with an 8-pound. It's a little harder trigger pull, but it's safer as far as not accidentally going off. Also, I am going to replace the carrier latch spring, which basically gives it a more positive, stronger lift than the current factory one. Okay, so I put the trigger assembly back in. I didn't have to use these pins because I put this cartridge shotgun shell carrier, and it came with its own pins. So it's looking good. Now I'm going to put the stock on and do the rear sight next. Putting on the rear sight. All right. Yeah, looks good. What else are we missing? So we put on the rear sight, put on this little sling ring here. I had to take the trigger assembly apart again because I forgot I got a new safety pin with a big ball there, so I can tell whether the safety is on and off without looking at it. I can feel it. You're good. So we came outside to show you the light in the shop was not so good. So, but here you go. It's pretty much finished. The whole thing took us a couple hours, probably painting and putting all the parts on. Not bad. Now I just need a sling and probably batteries for my light, but it's good. Very nice. Not too shabby.
Don't forget to subscribe.
Don't forget to subscribe. And find us on Facebook.